All right, I made a couple quick adjustments. I added two bitter blossoms to the deck and shaved the two dark rituals and a shriek maw, and added a basic swamp with the shriek maw to the sideboard of the dark blast. See if I play it against another dirtly type deck, if that helps out. See if bitter blossom's like a good strong card in the main deck. I think that like Phyrexian Crusader, bitter blossom can end the game by itself, especially when paired with a pike or a jit, so seems worth testing. Okay, and here we are on the play. Man, this hand seems lackluster. I'll try it. Yeah, just terrible. Please. I guess I've got like a discard spell, kind of a removal spell, sort of an almost threat, and an equipment to go on my almost threat. Not even gonna lead with it. Oh God. One ponder. Well, hopefully it's another Esper Blade deck and not a combo deck. It's most Underground Sea Ponder is most likely a combo deck. Probably Ad Nauseam. So I probably should have Funeral Charmed him turn one. Oh, he's dazing. Okay. Looks like I'm playing against a tempo deck then. Not combo. Probably bug. Yeah, you take that poison counter. So this hand's okay against tempo. Like, if he plays an unflipped Delver, I can Funeral Charm it. If he plays a Goy for a Tombstalker, I can dismember it. Probably going for Goyf here. It's currently a 4/5. So if I go end of turn dismember and he dazes again, I untap, animate both Ink Moths, send in, he attacks, puts me to 5 or whatever, and then I can jam Exile into Darkness next turn. Sweet. But he just F6'd, so he doesn't have anything going on over there. So right now my biggest concern is Tombstalker, which has thankfully fallen out of favor in some circles. I think I'd rather arena here than send in both. Ye olde double spell pierce. Guess I should have just attacked. Put him to 5. I'm just kind of giving him time, I guess. Getting the spell pierces out of his hand, in case he like slams Goyf, then I can exile into darkness it though. Like that's not bad. Cause my Ink Moths can't really race a Goyf at this point. Interesting. probably just takes the Exile into Darkness here, rather than potentially let me get value out of it later. Nope, I was wrong. I was really wrong. He did not want to have that go for the throat. So maybe that means he has a daze. Daze in hand. I think I'm fine running into that. Nope, he just sacrificing his creature. Maybe he wanted to buy tempo by taking the cheaper card, making me tap lower. I don't know. Sylvan Library. It's a tough card to beat. I'm still gonna name Wasteland. Maybe should have clicked him first. Really wish I hadn't ran Pike in the days, but that was before I even knew what was up. So it seems like I have some play in the tempo matchup. Probably just gonna lose to this Sylvan Library. Like his Phyrexian Arena resolved, mine didn't. Maybe should have just gotten back Tarmogoyf instead of this click. I don't know. The nice thing is that click prevents him from flashing in click to blow up my Ink Moth mid-combat. So I guess I should have just passed the turn. And then hopefully he just plays it, and then I can maybe get Exile back next turn. Oh well. Definitely need to stop playing extra lands. Loam and Exile into Darkness would work really well together. Clear away some of the stuff that Punishing Fire has trouble with. Since it's cost, it can get like Tarmogoyf and Nimble Mongoose, which Punishing Fire can't. God. Yeah, that's Sylvan Library. Well, that's a good one. So I get Evoke to hit his Tarmogoyf, or I can just cast the thing, and he's at 5 life. I think casting it seems pretty awesome. Runs into Daze, unfortunately, but I'm pretty sure the last card in his hand is not Daze. If this Brainstorm finds him a Daze, I'll feel stupid. Yeah. No. That was so bad. Very bad on my part. Yeah, I figured he wouldn't leave dazed in his hand with Sylvan. And he's like paying life over there and stuff. He just like ran out a bunch of threats. And I was right, like he didn't leave dazed in his hand, but yeah, if I had just evoked, I would be in a much better board state. However, if he hadn't found a daze, because like Force of Will doesn't do anything. So if he hadn't found a daze with that brainstorm, he'd be at 5 life and I'd have a 2-turn clock with the Shriek Maw. That's a decent draw. I think I am really close to dead on board, though. Yeah, I have to dish ship, because he can go activate Deathrite Shaman. Untap, activate Deathrite Shaman, which should put me to 1. So both my creatures have to jump. Maybe Needle should have named Deathrite instead of Wasteland. Somehow his Delver hasn't flipped despite him having Sylvan in play this whole time. Yeah, this was bad Needle. Maybe. Like, maybe he's shuffling around Wastelands on top of his library. So if I'd played this differently, you could have like 3 more infect counters right now. Still not really be dead, but it'd be a much closer game. Trying to decide if it's better to block with Ink Moth or Phyrexian Crusader here. It's difficult. I think Crusader. No. I think I'm dead either way, to be honest. Not drawing live here. Yeah, I'm trying to think of any live draws, and there just aren't. I used to have Damnation in here, but for situations like these. Gonna pack it in. Yeah, I'm not sure if I should have won that game, but it definitely should have been closer. Kind of awkward. So, Duress. Chains. I like chains against the 4 brainstorm, 4 ponder deck. Maybe Duress, maybe Shriek Maw. Needle only hits a few things, so I'll leave one in. Bitter Blossom can get cut. Cut down to one of it. Don't think Duress is better than the. And the cards I'm already running, maybe it is. Yeah, I'll try this.